بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. I'm Dr. هناء طارق الزواوي, Lecturer of Endocrinology, Faculty of Medicine, Alexandria University. My talk today in the conference was about disorders of sex development. Before discussing the disorders of sex development, first we should know how sexual development takes place. Sex development includes three major categories, which is the chromosomal sex, gonadal sex, and phenotypical anatomic sex. Also, a very important fourth component is the brain sex or the psychological sex. Any disorder in these categories or in these components leads to disorders of sexual development, or if any of those will develop not in an appropriate way, parallel to each other, results in disorders of sexual development. In the year 2006, a consensus statement was released by the Pediatric Endocrine Society and the European Society of Pediatric Endocrinologists to define disorders of sex development, or DSD. They define DSD as any congenital condition in which the development of chromosomal, gonadal, or phenotypic sex is atypical. Those patients are classified according to their karyotype into three categories: 40 sex chromosome DSD, 46XY DSD, and 46XX DSD. The most common of the sex chromosome DSD is the Turner syndrome. The most common in 46XY DSD is the androgen insensitivity syndrome. And the most common of 46XX DSD is the congenital adrenal hyperplasia syndrome. In fact, the diagnosis of DSD is particularly challenging, and it should be as early as possible because DSD represents a social emergency. So we should use all our available methods of diagnosis to reach a diagnosis as early as possible. The traditionally used is the ultrasound to detect the sex in utero. Also, MRI can be used to provide more accurate diagnosis. Karyotyping is used in the past using Koenig villus sampling and amniocentesis, now using a new technique called cell-free fetal DNA from the maternal blood. All these are ways to provide and reach a diagnosis, and also to counsel families and parents prior to conception. The aim of managing such cases are to provide ethical principles and to provide social and sexual relations with minimizing any psychosocial risks, and also to allow for fertility if this is possible. Current approaches include using hormone replacement therapy as the use of steroids in congenital adrenal hyperplasia cases, the use of testosterone therapy in hypogonadal men, use of growth hormone therapy in patients with Turner syndrome, also the use of cyclical estrogen and progesterone for these cases and other cases. Surgical reconstruction can be also done as feminizing genitoplasty in patients with congenital adrenal hyperplasia, and also gonadectomy for fear of malignancy. Future directions are to create registries and form a large network of researchers and data in order to make more research in this field in order to pinpoint the genetic cause and allow counseling for the parents prior to conception. And if DSD occurred, treatment should be done as early as possible. Finally, DSD represents a social emergency and a medical dilemma. Therefore, an accurate and timely diagnosis is an essential in the treatment. Thank you.